Hello world, this is S Gold. I'm here to demonstrate SkyControl, a reusable sky simulation that I created for a 3D game. It runs on jMonkey Engine, an open source 3D game engine written in Java. SkyControl was originally based on Tone God's Sky Dome, which I downloaded from the jMonkey Platform Contributions Project at Google Code. I'm very grateful to Tone God, both for publishing Sky Dome and also for encouraging me to build upon it. I'll start by demonstrating the major features of SkyControl. I'll talk about how it works, how the project is structured, and where I hope to take it in the future. So here's a little demo app called Test SkyControl, and I'll run that and pick a nice big screen. And the app brings up a scene with some terrain. There's a ring of green hills. There's a monument that looks a bit like Stonehenge. And of course, there's a sky generated by SkyControl. The monument is casting shadows on the terrain, and the shadows are rendered using JME's directional light shadow renderer, and that uses the main light direction vector computed by SkyControl. On the right, there's a heads-up display, or HUD, implemented using Nifty, and the HUD contains 7 sliders which modify the scene in various ways. And for instance, by adjusting the shadow intensity, I can make the shadows disappear. View azimuth and time of day are displayed at the top of the HUD. Right now, it's looking 10 degrees north of west, and the time is 4:45 in the morning. And the simulation is running at speed of 1, which means 1 simulation second per real second. The full moon is low in the west. In fact, it's in the constellation Orion, which is about to set. These 3 stars here are his belt. This V-shaped asterism is the face of Taurus the Bull. And here are the Pleiades, or 7 sisters. While SkyControl is not 100% accurate from an astronomy point of view, my star maps are generated from a real star catalog, so players can stargaze in my game. When I press H, that disables the HUD. It also enables flycam, so I can dolly and zoom around in the scene, just like a real fly. By dragging with the left mouse button, I can tilt up here, so I'm looking directly overhead, and there is the Big Dipper. And these 2 stars in the bowl of the Big Dipper are known as the pointers, and they will point me to the North Star, and there's the Little Dipper, there's the bowl, there's the handle. And so if I bring up the HUD now, I can see that I'm actually looking pretty much due north. I'm going to go back now to the monument so we can watch what happens with the shadows when the simulation is moving through time here. Okay, so I can make the clouds go away for better viewing, or I can make them denser and faster moving, which increases the drama of the scene. The clouds derive from a can texture, and at normal cloud speed, the pattern would repeat after about 10 minutes. But there are actually 2 cloud layers moving at different speeds and in slightly different directions, and so players are unlikely to notice any repetition of the sky. I'll click the Modulate Main Light button, the checkbox, and when that's set, you notice how the scene flickers a little bit as the clouds pass in front of the moon, dimming its light. Since our time together is limited, I'm going to speed up the simulation now. Let's have it go 10, 100, 1,000 times normal speed, and the moon sets, the sun rises, and the sun starts moving across the southeastern sky. And the shadows are moving clockwise as well as the sun moves across the sky. And you can see from the clock the time is getting now into late morning. It's 11 o'clock. And you follow the sun's progress across the sky. And let's go a little faster. Okay, so now it's sunset, which is my favorite time of day. I'm going to lower the hills here, so you can see the sunset a little bit better. Notice how the edge of the sky and the clouds are now orange, as is the light that's being shed on the scene by the sun. In fact, I think sunsets are so cool, I'm going to move to the North Pole, where the sunset can last for a couple days. Or maybe the South Pole. Same situation. And one cool thing about sunrise and sunset is it's the one time of day when you can see the sun and the full moon at the same time. So I'm going to pan around here and find where is the full moon. Oh, there it is. Okay, so now it's time to take a break from looking at the lovely graphics and browse some lovely source code. I've packaged up the SkyControl, so hopefully it will be easy for people to reuse in their own games. The package is, of course, named after the class SkyControl, which, as you might have guessed, is a custom JME control. It can be added to any node in the scene graph. It has a simple constructor, which generates the special purpose dome geometry using this class dome mesh. And it applies sky material, which is another class, an animated custom texture to the dome. And the dome then gets attached to the scene graph when you enable the control using set enabled. Set enabled in SkyControl. There it is. The control also has accessors for changing cloud modulation, setting the cloud rate, changing the cloudiness, changing the time, changing the latitude, changing the declination of the sun, and so on. So it's pretty easy to get it working. And in case SkyControl doesn't do exactly what you want, perhaps you want to simulate a Martian sky instead of an Earth sky, you can bypass it completely and work directly with sky material. Like many software projects, this is a work in progress. My next milestone is to add star motion to the simulation. Maybe you didn't notice, but during the demo earlier, Orion stayed put on the west horizon, while in real life, the stars would rise and set, moving at about the same rate as the sun and the moon. There's currently a flag to enable this feature for testing, and I'm confident enough that I will enable it now and show off how that's going to look when I have it working 100%. So going back into the program again, test SkyControl, and lower the horizon again. Okay, now it's a different time of day. We don't have Orion on the scene here because the clouds are in a different orientation. I mean, the stars are in a different orientation. But as I turn up the speed, you see the stars start to move with the moon across the sky, setting in the west just as they do in real life. And there's Orion. And then, of course, during the day, the stars disappear. The approach I've taken is to create three dome geometries instead of one. The two outer domes have the stars textured onto them, one for the northern stars and one for the southern stars. And then there's a third dome, which has the sky material on it with the sun and the clouds and the moon and so forth. And that's translucent, so at night the stars are allowed to shine through. So that's how it looks. Should be pretty straightforward if you wanted to add planets, comets, auroras, and so on. Likewise, you could add textures for specific phases of the moon, for eclipses and so on, pretty easily. More ambitious enhancement would be to animate the phases of the moon so that the moon's apparent shape would vary continuously instead of having discrete phases. Other changes I've considered would include adding color to the star maps and getting the moon's orientation just right. I'm not sure if these are worth the trouble because the intent, after all, is to support games. Not to create a virtual planetarium, which is where this seems to be headed. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video. The source code is, of course, up on Google Code with a GPL license, and in theory, you could use Subversion to check out the source code. However, I haven't yet packaged it up for easy distribution, so you may want to wait a while. Perhaps the code will end up in the Contributions Project on Google Code or in JME itself, or perhaps it will become a plugin. I don't know yet. The names of the packages, classes, and methods are subject to change, so my advice would be stay tuned for further developments. Anyway, hope you're excited about those as I am. This is S. Gold signing off. Good night, world, and sweet dreams.